Grow your foundation. A pure and uncomplicated soldier. 6'2", the heart and soul of your team. And 07.
What's going on, everyone? Great Talon here, and the prey today will be Star Wars Republic Commando for the Xbox, released February of 2005. My God, it feels such a long time ago, doesn't it? 14 years ago. Look how far we've come. We're actually not so far we've come, because the state of Star Wars games has slowly degraded and almost become non-existent over time, thanks to the likes of Disney and EA alike. But we won't talk about that today. We'll keep it positive today. We're gonna just focus on the good. We'll save the negativity and the criticism for another video. But yeah, so you guys don't know, if you are an Xbox Live member right now, a Gold member, and you subscribe to Xbox Live Gold, you can download this title for free right now. I'm gonna link the link to the game on the Xbox Store in the description as well, so you guys can check that out. But yeah, this was great. This was a time, and this was probably one of the only, I guess you could say, Clone Wars inspired first person shooter video games that you actually play as the clone troopers, the 501st Legion of the Clone Army. This elite squad that was trained differently than the other clones. A little backstory there, as you can see on the screen right now. It's just giving you a little backstory. Delta Squad is an elite group of commandos that were trained differently than just the generic foot soldiers. They were like the kind of like the tactical squad. Like if you ever play Rainbow Six, you know, like they're just like the utmost elite squad, like a SWAT team almost. So, and so the game is played entirely first person view. You can have like a nice neat little visor with like a HUD there, similar to the Metroid Prime games. You can command your squad too. If anybody's familiar with squad-based games such as Brothers in Arms, XCOM, you can actually tell your squad where to go, what to do, and everything. You'll see that showcased here in a minute. But this is just the opening level, and what I love about this game, it stands out a lot because it's a first-person shooter video game. But it's honestly. It's for me anyway. At the time when I was first playing it in 2005, it was like Call of Duty meets Star Wars, because it's a first-person shooter, it's fast-paced, high-octane action, and you know, you're commanding elite squad too along with it. And this game takes place, and you know, it was during a golden time for Star Wars, a golden era of Star Wars. You know, it was back when LucasArts was in their prime. They were just pumping out game after game, and this game came out 3 months before Revenge of the Sith, the last great Star Wars movie as we know. So yeah, this was really a great game. I was just, you know, glamored by it. Even to this day, it looks really good, and especially if you're playing on an Xbox One X, the rendering is upscaled, so you're gonna get it's gonna appear to be a faster frame rate. It's gonna be smoother polygons, smoother textures, and so on and so forth. See what I just did there? I just commanded my team member to Fixer to open the door. So actually, Scorcher told him to open the door, and he's planting explosives, and he's gonna set a charge there, and we're gonna blast the door. See, it's very tactical. So. And this game, when it came out, it got, you know, favorable reviews. It got like, aggregated scores of, I think, 8s on the 80s, up in the high 80s on Metacritic. And yeah, it was a great game for the time. And yeah, this was really, really a fun game for me. I'm just gonna play through these levels, and you know, I'll just walk you guys through it. You know, this is like an informal let's play. And at the same time, is it worth your time? Yes. Anybody who has an Xbox Live membership, go download this right now for free. It is absolutely gratuita, and it's free for all if you have an Xbox Live membership. And if not, it's only $9.99, and you can play one of the better Star Wars games out there that has been released in the past 14 years. It's not the best Star Wars game, in my opinion. But it's bloody well good. I mean, it's better than, honestly, I posted Jedi Academy, my playthrough of that, a little let's play of that last week. I liked Jedi Academy. I didn't love it. It felt dated. There was a lot of glitches, a lot of things that were bouncing around in there that shouldn't have been. But Republic Commando's tight. It's airtight. It's 14 years old and it's airtight. There's There's really nothing. I actually will finish this game. This is just an introductory video right now, but I'm going to finish this game. I'm going to finish it again. I beat it 14 years ago, and I'm going to beat it again now. And the introductions here, as you can see, of the other team members are just phenomenal. You have a guy beating the hell out of a Genosian. You have another guy who's just freaking sniping. It's great. It's truly a delight to play a good Star Wars game again. That's been revitalized in a sense and brought to us in a different instance, you know, bring it backwards compatibility. And that's another thing I want to touch on too, guys and gals. Xbox has just been slaying it, giving us month after month after month of wonderful backwards compatibility games. Granted, their exclusives aren't what they should be right now, but in the marketplace, but right now, they are truly just killing it with backwards compatibility. This month alone, Republic Commando and Metal Gear Rising for the 360. Metal Gear Rising, one of the craziest over-the-top action games of last generation, developed by none other than Platinum Star, is actually available for free this month if you are an Xbox Live member. I'm also going to link that in the description as well to the store. That is available from the 15th. Of March to the 31st of March. I'm going to put the dates in the description as well. Don't worry, I'm going to take care of everyone. That's what I do. And I got a couple minutes left here, so I just want to also, I'm just giving you guys updates on the channel, you know, as you guys are watching this. If you've come this far anyway, I know some of you people probably clicked away already, but that's okay. If you guys are still with me, next I'm going to try and beat Metro Exodus today. I'm almost done with it. I'm about 3/4 of the way done. I'm going to post my review on that. It's not going to be an in-depth review like my Resident Evil or Kingdom Hearts reviews, because I'm reserving the reviews for the games I truly love and adore, formal written reviews and in turn video reviews of that. Only the games I truly think are worth your time. But Metro Exodus, honestly, I'm forcing myself to get to the end. It's really been a chore. Metro Exodus is an open world-ish game, and Metro has not been really well designed as an open world game, and I'll touch on that in my review. And also other things to look forward to in the channel. There's also, I'm going to be working hard on a weekly series similar to what the, if you guys are familiar with Jim Sterling's work, the Jim Position, I'm going to do a weekly series touching on the video game industry. I'm going to be, my first episode is going to be called What Happened to the B-Level Video Games Out There, B-Rated Games, what happened to that in the marketplace and where the industry is headed with in terms of, you know, saturating the market with the games that feature live services and AAA games and all of this other nonsense that is keeping the B-Level video games from truly rising back and becoming a present force in the gaming industry today. So with that being said, I'm just going to bid you adieu and let you guys finish watching. This is only about a minute left here, so just enjoy the rest of this video, and we'll talk to you guys later. You guys have a great day, and listen, if you haven't already, subscribe and share this video. I will love you tremendously, even if you do or you don't. But if you share and subscribe, it just gives me more incentives to keep pumping out more videos for you guys. And, you know, newcomers alike and oldcomers, you know, like, I can keep pumping out as more and more videos, the more shares and subscribers I get. So, you know, that is be much obliged, much appreciated. So, in the meantime, I'm just going to keep doing what I'm doing like this, while showcasing a bunch of other things I have in the works, in the pipeline as well. So, got a bunch of things I want to bring up and want to showcase and talk about, and will in time. Best is yet to come, and everyone have a great day. Thanks for watching.